What's going on, my friends? This is Dustin Stelzer with Electrician U. Today's episode, we're going to talk a little bit about stripping wire using different methodologies, hand stripping, using tools, and everything around stripping wires. Before we begin, I just want to point out that this video is sponsored by Milwaukee. Thank you so much, Milwaukee. It is a part of their grid program. So those of you that don't know what Milwaukee Grid is, it's an entire hub for apprentices. So if you're new to an apprenticeship or you're about to get into an apprenticeship, the grid has a whole bunch of different videos and resources and things. They do giveaways, they send out newsletters with extra information. So there's a whole bunch of resources involved with the Milwaukee Grid program. There's a link in the description below. Let's say we're gonna do these four receptacles. So, right, I've got all these different tools that have the ability to strip. What else do I got? I got needle nose that strip. Like, look at how many options I have. You'll notice that I just randomly pull tools out when I'm working. And I like all of these cut, all of these strip, all of these bend, all of these almost, actually no, every single one of them has a threading tool, well, except that one. But you can put threads in that and actually cut a bolt down and it doesn't mess up the ends of the threads. So I have all these different options and we'll talk about them. This one right here is just a preference that I have because it does number 8. So it does really large conductors and it, you know, it's a clean strip for me when I've got like large stranded number 8. But I like how small it is. Like it's really, really small, compact, fits in your hand. I keep these because these are kind of like a pair of lineman's pliers. They've got that, you know, blunt edge so I can twist wire nuts or twist wires for putting wire nuts on, but it still has a bunch of stripping options and it still has bolt cutters. It still cuts. And ergonomically, I kind of like how the handles are bent. So I might use that one for something. This one's just another kind of like generic use. One that, it, you know, doesn't have any large sizes or anything, just kind of your typical sizes, but it does, oh, it actually does have the threading and the bolt cutting. Needle nose I use for everything and I just figure, well, if I'm already gonna have needle nose, I might as well have the stripping and the cutting and the, you know, there's a crimping option in there too. And then these I love. These things are super clean and crisp. They work just like needle nose. And they've got enough grip up here too that you can kind of, you know, like really grab onto something. They've got this outer edge that's a little bit riveted. So if I'm ever like cleaning out some conduit, I can stick that in there. They've got the bolt cutting options. They've got this inside cutting edge. And it's the only ones that I've seen that have like kind of a curved cutting edge. That usually you just don't see that. Plus it goes from number 8 all the way number 18 for solid. Stranded goes from 10 to 20. So just really good. So when you strip out, one thing that you want to think about is the insulation around these conductors is stuck really well to it. So if you try to say like, just cut this and pull it off, it'll come off, but you're gonna have a little bit harder time if you keep the tool 90 degrees to the wire. It'll still come off, that's totally fine. But what I've found over the years is if I take, instead of going straight on like this, if I kick the tool back a little bit and then strip, do that, then all you have to do is turn the tool like this and it already pops the wire off. So it's like, it just comes off so much easier. That's just a method that I use. Let me do it again. Like every time I strip anything, I go boom and then pop it and go. Now, the one thing that you don't wanna do is you don't wanna like go at an angle like this and try to pull it off at an angle. It's not gonna come off. I've seen helpers do this over and over. They're like, why won't it come off? It's like, dude, straighten the tool out. You have a cutting edge that's like digging into that copper right now. It's sharp, you know, like you're actually digging into it. So yeah, so you need to strip it and pop it straight and then it comes right off, nice and pretty. So let's see how quick we can strip doing that method. Boom, bend, boom, bend. Boom, like no resistance at all, right? Just super easy. Now, if you're just gonna use a regular stripper instead of one of those, I'd do the same thing. It's a little bit easier to tell how dramatic it is, but just boom. Another thing too, when I'm stripping, I don't ever let go, like with my left hand. When I'm holding on, I hold on so that I can use this tool right here. I see a lot of apprentices that will go like this and then they'll let go and then they'll sit and try to strip and then they're like fighting this wire. Like, no, grab onto this thing. When you go to strip, like use your fingers kind of as a guide as to where to put the tool and then strip off. Sometimes I will like push with my finger if I'm feeling like the, you know, the wire is not gonna slide as easily. But look, I like lay the tool on my fingers and then I do my angle, pop it off, and then you can still hang on and then just push with your finger. That works also. Or sometimes you'll see what I just did there. See, there's a whole bunch of different methods. It's just kind of stuff that you get used to while you're doing this. But yeah, a lot of times I'll bend it and I'll actually grab on with the rest of my fingers and I'll just use my thumb to push the tool up. So there's all kinds of little tips and tricks and things that you're gonna learn over the years. But really it's just like getting your fingers used to doing the same thing. Now when I bend hooks, I use this stripper and I put it inside of that loop and I hold onto it firmly with my hand on the back side of what I stripped off with this finger and I bend the hook. I don't go like this and let go and then try to bend a hook, because look what happens. Like you just, it's a shitty, you know, huge like crappy hook. So you always want to control the end that you're working with. So I usually put a little bit in there. I don't go all the way through like this. I just go at the very tip and then I roll it. And I roll it tightly, as tight as that tool will allow me to make it. Now, so the benefit of using different tools to bend your hooks is like with this, because of this tool, look at how skinny it is. So I'm gonna be able to roll a lot tighter hook with something like that than something like this. You know, I could stick to the tip and I could roll something really tight, or I could go back here and it just gives me a little bit more control to bend a hook that's a little bit, you know, thicker. Same thing, you know, if I wanted to use these, I could do the same thing. I could just take the very tip of it and I could roll a hook. But that tool's not gonna allow me to get very tight. So, you know, just, it all of it works. It's all okay. Even, you know, regular needle nose, boom. Every one of them are okay. It's just kind of what you get used to and how you do things. But those are just some of the things that I do. Now, another thing that we're gonna come across when we are stripping out conductors is conductors of different sizes, so much larger conductors. And for that, we've got some tools at our disposal. So if we are doing really big conductors, we've got really big dies that we could use to put inside of this tool. And then the end of the tool, or the end of the wire, we would stick inside of this and it strips off. I don't have any wire that's that big to test any of this with. Let's see what sizes I do have though. 2-aught AWG. So I'm gonna take my 2-aught AWG die, stick it in here. There's a little lever on the side. That's your release. Make sure it twists in place. And then it's just gonna twist as you feed a wire in there. So put this in there and see how it takes the insulation off. Now that didn't take it off very much, so we have to adjust the depth for whatever we want. So like, let's say we want 2 inches of the end to be stripped off. We pull that thing out, retighten this so that this stays, then that moves the inside of the tool back more. So now when I do it again, I can go way deep inside of there. Look how much of that's going in. Pull it out, boom, you're stripped off. Look how quick that was. So back in the day before we had tools like this, we had to literally take our knife and we had to score the entire side of this by hand. And most people that don't have those tools are still doing it this way. I'm not gonna lie, sometimes I'm out in the field and I don't have that. So I take this, helps if you take like a needle nose or something and grab onto it and pull it off. So you can do the same thing. It's just a little bit more arduous when you've got all of these different conductors to mess with. You know, it's just more time consuming. This tool saves you a whole bunch of time. All right, so that's let's just skip to the biggest size that I've got, 4-aught AWG. So we'll go 400, 4-aught. Stick that thing in. Make sure it snaps in place. Hit the trigger. And boom, so quick, so efficient. Now, I don't have any dies that are smaller than 1-aught, so pretty much anything smaller than 1-aught, I have to do by hand. So let's look at, I don't know, this is probably number 2. Yeah, this is 4 AWG. So I would do the same thing. One way I could do this, I could cut it and just score all the way around and then go at an angle and cut all of that off. You can try to peel it off by hand, or takes a little bit more time, but you have to put your tool down, pick up another tool, put the tool down and go back. Or you could, number 8 and number 6 are really good for this. At number 4, it starts to become a little bit more difficult, but you could just score right around this thing. You gotta be careful. You don't wanna like mess up any of those conductors. So when you score, you're just kind of lightly doing this. You could score with the cutting edge, or you can actually score with the teeth. It all works the same. But then you use your thumb to sit and try to pull that off. Now, it's a pain in the butt when you're doing this with bigger conductors because these are spun, so you actually kind of have to spin this while you're pulling it off. It's just a little bit more arduous. After a while, your thumb's gonna be in pain when you're doing it that way. So it's just more of a pain in the butt way to do it. That's why a lot of people with these bigger ones, they'll just take their knife, they'll score the end, cut around it, and then either with their fingers pull it off, or they'll take some tool and pull it off. But that, my folks, is stripping conductors.
All right, one last time I wanna thank Milwaukee for sending these rad strippers and combination strippers needle nose. These things are really cool. If you guys have not yet, make sure if you're an apprentice, go check out the grid program. There's a link in the description below. There's all kinds of useful resources. So once you get into your apprenticeship, they've got a whole bunch of stuff there for you. Thank you guys so much for watching. I really appreciate your attention, and I will see you in the next episode.
Discount music and video.